Okay, we're in Zimbabwe right now. We're in a company called Label It Trading as Global Plastics. And this is one of the biggest plastic bag manufacturers in Zimbabwe and for the region. You're standing in front of a machine, and I'm not going to go into big detail of this. The machine is something that makes plastic bags. It starts with granules, goes through heater, goes up there, goes through rollers, ends up as plastic bags here. Now we've got a power outage. This is what a lot of people don't realize when it comes to a power outage, is that here is the critical part here, and this little part here is critical. I want Nick Palmer to explain to me the granules to there. Nick, this is the critical part when there's a power outage. This is where wastage, this is where wasted money, wasted product comes in. Explain to us how it works.
Pat, what happens here is that we take plastics that come from our supply in solid form. They go through a heated barrel and screw, and at this stage, that material, that solid, is turned into a liquid and is pumped through. This is basically a pump, and it'll pump it through into a die, which then forms the plastic from there. In the event of a power outage, everything stops, and what happens is that the residual heat in the barrel, which is heating the plastic to around about 220 degrees, stops that process, and that residual heat will then burn the material. If that power outage goes beyond the roughly the 10-minute mark, we then have to start from scratch, and we'd have to purge the barrel and screw out. In this process, if the power cut, which is inevitably longer than 10 minutes and going for a couple of hours, once we get power back, this whole process has to begin again just by heating it up. And what's been burnt and becomes charcoal in the barrel now has to be purged. And that takes material, the normal virgin material that we buy at great expense, and that is the only way we can purge these barrels and screws. And that is quite an expense that has to be costed in somewhere along the line. But on once in a while basis, you can understand, but when it happens on a daily basis, this is a serious cost factor that we have to include. And it's nothing we can do to alleviate or avoid this. Generators are possible, but these are very extravagant energy users, and the generators required are costly. The cost of fuel is very high in Zimbabwe, and the availability is another issue as well. So all of these compound the whole thing into quite a big headache, but we just sit and hope for the best.
And that is the hassle that a Zimbabwean company like Label It has to go through on a daily basis. And there's a huge waste of material, and in fact, they're very resilient in Zimbabwe. Nick and all the guys around you, this is now used to be pure product, now you have some recycled product in, etc., etc. They make a plan over here, but the inconvenience, the cost, there's a whole warehouse at the back there filled of wasted material. So that's it.